just came here to bring you good vibes.
That's all I came to do.
And I just want you to have a good time.
Real good time.
Good vibes, good vibes. Oh, I just came here to bring you good vibes.
Good vibes only. Good vibes only.
Oh, and I just want you to have a good time.
Real good time.
Good vibes, good vibes.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to
the hypocritic Christian in the land of no religion. So easy to judge, but so hesitant to love. Always preaching perfection, but living with an infection. And the world sees this and rises up with cries, pointing their fingers towards the building and saying it's all full of lies. But the problem isn't the building, because the church is the people. People who are broken and find hope under a steeple. They're all hypocrites and they all lie. No, we're all imperfect, but we try. I've been that kid who only obeys God when it's convenient. I've made bad choices and said, God, I'm sorry, when I didn't really mean it. I've had doubting faith, asking God, why did you bring me to this place? I've questioned the world around me. I've tried to be the God of my own life, and that never seemed to crown me. But I know that God is my ruler, so I give him my life. And I know if I never wake, I'll be in heaven tonight. So I know I'm not perfect, but Jesus died for my sins when I certainly didn't deserve it. Every day I'm fighting, trying to conquer my own flesh. And every day I realize it needs to be God more and me less. Cause I'm getting weary of this fake smile, acting like everything's the best. I've tried to lay my head on my pillow, but only in him can I find rest. Cause each new battle brings some of the same old temptation. And I know I could always give in and say, oh, shame on you, Satan. But I'm not doing this on my own. God's with me when I'm all alone. He's there when I fail, and he doesn't define me on my past, and he lets my sins sail away. Cause Christ died then for my today. So if by hypocritic Christian you mean imperfect, then yes, I am him. But that's the reason I'm not the one I put my faith in.
Amen, amen, amen. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Let me welcome you to St. Paul CME Church Worship Service for Sunday, March 14th, 2021. To God be the glory. We welcome you all who are joining us today, members, friends, and guests. We thank you for you joining us today as we worship our Lord and Savior in spirit and in truth. Let me share with you a few announcements and reminders before we start our worship today. First, let me share with you that on March 16th, of course, we will have our leadership retreat follow-up at 6:30 p.m. That will be led by our lay leader, Brother Roxton Simmons, and one of our stewards, Sister Gwen Ross, who are the leaders of this leadership retreat. And so please, all leaders and those who have led our various breakout groups, you need to be part of this retreat follow-up at 6:30 on March 16th. And then on March 18th, which is Thursday, we will have a Youth and Young Adult Conference parent and attendee meeting. That'll be at 7 p.m. That'll be led by our Director of Christian Education, Sister Tracy Simmons. And I will be in attendance as well. However, we need all of our parents, as well as those who had planned to attend the National Youth and Young Adult Conference and was registered. So please be at that meeting of importance. And then on March 19th, there will be a candidates forum hosted by the Third Episcopal District. And you should have received the Zoom link information for that. That'll be at 6 p.m. And it'll be a candidates forum all those individuals who are running for the episcopacy, that Zoom meeting or that Zoom form will be on March 19th, which is a Friday at 6 p.m. And then, of course, next Sunday will be our Stewards Board annual day. They will be leading us throughout the entire worship. And I know that you will be blessed. The stewards have been working diligently and hard to prepare and put together a wonderful service. You don't want to miss it. Please invite friends, loved ones, and visitors to join us for that day. And then on March 23rd, we will have a strategic planning listening tour. That will be hosted by the 3rd Episcopal District. That will be at 7 p.m. And I will make sure that you receive the Zoom link leading up to that day. Some of you should have received it already, but I will make sure that you receive that information leading up to that day. On March 27th, of course, is our monthly St. Paul movie night at 6 p.m. And again, leading up to that day, I will share with you the movie that we will be viewing on that day. And then, of course, on March 28th will be Palm Sunday. And I will share with you via email how we will go about celebrating Palm Sunday, since we won't physically be in the church. Many of you received your COVID vaccine. For those who were not able to get the vaccine, we will be coordinating another round of vaccinations. If you desire to receive the vaccine, please email me or text me your name. I will get you on the list. We have partnered with Allen Metropolitan CME Church and Roseland Community Hospital to make sure that we get individuals vaccinated. So please, please, please forward your name and information to me so that I can get you on the list right away. Last but not least, as we prepare to prepare for Resurrection Sunday and our annual Easter program, Sister Jacqueline Prince, as well as Sister Kim Owens, is overseeing that day, and they will be giving out assignments for the Easter program. And you are asked to reach out to Sister Jacqueline Prince to receive your speeches for that day. I will put her phone number in the chat. And for those who don't have chat, let me give that number to you right now. 773-294-8936. Again, that's 773-294-8936. And she will be giving out the speeches for our young people and those striving to be young for our annual Easter program. Just remind you that as we prepare for worship, understand that we are virtual. And if you're not part of the liturgy today, please keep your audio muted. And then also turn off your video if you don't want to be seen. And at the appropriate time when asked, you can unmute yourselves. For those on your phone, you hit *6. For those on their computer, you hit mute button to unmute yourselves as it relates to that. Also, just be mindful that if you have any technical difficulties, please use the chat option to notify us and we will work to correct it. Please do not blurt out a shout out during worship that something is wrong technically. We just need you to put it in your chat or text Sister Lisa and I, and we will address it right away. Thank you so much, and let us now prepare and start worship. Amen.
Everybody say, amen, amen, amen. In my school, say, amen. In my school, say, amen. In my school, say, amen, amen, amen. While I play, say, amen. While I play, say, amen. While I play, say, amen, amen, amen. In my home, say, amen. In my home, say, amen. In my home, say, amen, amen, amen. Let the church say, amen. Let the church say, amen. Let the church say, amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Amen. Let the church say, amen. Thank you, Trinity. Amen. Amen. We'll now be led in prayer and our affirmation of faith by Brother Rutherford Simmons III.
Good morning, St. Paul. Can everyone bow their heads and close their eyes? Dear Lord, I want to thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you've done and everybody's lives that are here today. Please help the pastor as he brings the word. Help it to minister to some people here today. Please help the pastor to preach a good word. Help somebody to be blessed by this word today. Please help our world as we are dealing with COVID-19. Help us all to know that you are with us and that you will never leave or forsake us, Lord. I want you to help everybody who is performing today to do well and to worship you in song or in word. And Lord, I want you to also help the sick and shut-in who are sick, and I want you to heal them, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Brother Rutherford Simmons III. Let us now be blessed by our praise dance ministry, Sister Kyla Owens.
Eyes have never seen, minds have never dreamed, thoughts have never conjured up. Man tries to tear it up, but I know what it is. anointing. It's the anointing. Oh. Books try to explain. Movies try to portray. Novelties dress it up. Documentaries mess it up.
To God be the glory. Thank you, Sister Kyla, for blessing us in dance. To God be the glory. Amen. Let us now hear and receive the word of God. We will first receive the Old Testament reading from Brother Cameron Rayford, and then following him, the New Testament by Brother B.J. Owens. Let us now receive Brother Rayford.
Good morning, my St. Paul family. I'll be reading Numbers chapter 24, verses 4 through 9. The word reads as follows. He hath said, which heard the words of God, which saw the vision of the Almighty, falling into a trance, but having his eyes open. How godly are thy tents, O Jacob, and thy tabernacles, O Israel. as the valleys are they spread forth, as gardens by the river's side, as the trees of line aloes, which the Lord hath planted, and as cedar trees beside the waters. He shall pour the water out of his buckets, and his seed shall be in many waters, and his king shall be higher than Agag, and his kingdom shall be exalted. But God brought him forth out of Egypt. He hath his, He hath, as it were, strength of a unicorn. He shall eat up the nation's enemies and shall break their bones and pierce them through with his arrows. He couched, he lay down as a lion, as a great lion. Who shall stir him up? For blessed is he that blesseth thee, and the curse, and cursed is he that curseth thee. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I have just read for my church family, Numbers chapters 24, verses 4 through 9. Amen.
Good morning, St. Paul. I'll be reading. Good morning, St. Paul. I'll be reading John chapter 3, verses 13 through 12. It reads, "No one has ever gone into heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, though that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe in him stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God, one and only Son. This is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light, because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear that their deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth comes into the light, so that it may be seen plainly that what they have done has been done in the sight of God." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Amen. Thank you, Brother Cameron and Brother BJ, for reading of God's word. Thank you so much. Amen, amen, amen. We'll now be blessed in song. Amen. 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 I don't know about you, but I think it's just time to take a praise break. Amen. Wherever you are, just give God the praise, honor, and glory. Amen. Our young people have led us magnificently today. I am just thanking and praising God for their ministry to us today. Amen. Let's just give God praise wherever you are. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Amen. 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 Let me thank both Cameron and BJ for reading our scriptures today. I want to draw your attention back to the text that was read for your hearing in the Gospel of John. The Gospel of John, chapter 3, verses 14 to 21, I will be reading. And I'll be reading from the NIV translation. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he have not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deed should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. The word of God for the people of God, thanks be to God. I want to speak from the subject this morning. The devil made me do it. The devil made me do it. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we come thanking and praising you for your loving kindness and tender mercies. We thank you, dear God, for our order of worship today. And we thank you, dear God, for our young people who have led us so well, dear God. We thank you for the anointing on their lives. And we thank you, dear God, for how you used them in the upbuilding of your kingdom. Lord, I ask now, as always, that you decrease Curlee, that they see none of me, but all of thee. And in the end, Lord, you will get the honor, you will get the glory, and you will get the praise and all that is said and done. But then, Lord, when we extend the invitation to discipleship, there may be one, there may be others, dear God, who has not given their lives to you. But as a result of today, dear God, they speak up and speak out, asking, what can I do to be saved? But in the meantime, Lord, any way you bless us, any way you bless us, we'll be satisfied. For it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The devil made me do it. During our journey with God in life, we often hear someone say from time to time, the devil made me do it. When we hear this phrase, normally something unpleasant or unexpected has happened. When the person is approached about their actions, their response is, the devil made me do it. Other times, I believe believers has used this term like some get out of jail free card for their illicit and disobedient behavior. Clearly, we know we have done wrong. Yet when challenged or approached about it, we project blame on the devil when we know we wanted to do it all along. Yet as we reflect on this statement, there's also another way to look at this phrase. Saying the devil made me do it can also be the result of you doing something good and pleasing unto God. Because you knew what the devil was capable of and you knew what the devil could do, you did something to ensure that the devil would not get the victory. This is the foundation of our message today. Jesus' actions on the cross was not only about what God wanted to achieve through his people, but also what God was trying to prevent through his son. In our chosen text, we come to the point where Jesus is speaking to Nicodemus, who had approached Jesus at night. He came inquiring about Jesus's identity and deity. Jesus explains to Nicodemus the requirements for entering the kingdom of God. Jesus tells Nicodemus, you must be born again. Nicodemus begins to question Jesus' response to him by saying, how can a person be old and born again? Jesus then tells him, unless a man been born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Jesus begins to unpack this entire statement by stressing the point that new birth is only obtained through him. Because of his ultimate death and the belief in that death and resurrection, we can have a new life with God. It is from that point Jesus goes right into that famous passage of scripture we have memorized from childhood. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Understand, as believers, there is an enemy that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But John tells us through the words of Jesus, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. The enemy do not want you to be saved. The enemy do not want you to live for God. The enemy do not want you to experience what God plans for you, and the enemy surely do not want you to have eternal life with God. Knowing all of this, God understands, and I know Jesus understood, that something needed to be done to cancel the enemy's power. And so Jesus, through God himself the Father, allowed his son to be sacrificed, to understand and know that what led him was not only to save us, but to make sure that the enemy, the devil, would not have us. So the devil made him do it. What do we learn from this? Why did Jesus do this to cancel the Satan's power? Well, first of all, he lets us know that we need to know the power of having faith in Jesus. Let me break this down for you. In the beginning of the pericope, it points out that Jesus was lifted up just like Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness. Let me break this down to you even further. For those who may not remember this story, in Numbers 21, verses 4 through 9, it depicts a story where the children of Israel got upset with Moses because of their struggles in the wilderness. And they began to complain to Moses and say to him, we would have been better off back in Egypt instead of going through what we're going through right now. So the Lord got upset with them, sent a serpent through the camp, and the serpent began to bite a number of the Israelites, and many of them died. When they realized the errors of their way, they called out to Moses. Moses called out to God. And what God told Moses was to take the serpent, put him on a staff, put him up in the wilderness. And when the people look at the serpent, they'll be saved. But here it is now in the Gospel of John. Jesus alludes to that same story. And he said, just like the people looked to the serpent look to the serpent to be healed, to be saved. So do we look to Jesus to be healed and to be saved. But the lifting up and us looking up to Jesus is an act of faith in believing that Jesus can do what God has said that he can do in his word. Let me break it down to you even further. The issue with the Israelites is that they were looking back in the past, thinking the past was better than their future. Some of us are right now don't believe what the Lord can do with your future because you're still locked in the past. You won't let go of the past, and God is trying to take you to the future. And just because you have some bumps in the road, just because you have some issues in your life, just because you have some struggles, doesn't mean that God doesn't have something special for you. The same way the people of Israel looked up to that serpent is the same way we need to look to Jesus in faith for our lives. Oh, good God Almighty. Here's some good news for somebody. Because we stay too much locked in the past. And we sometimes say to ourselves, maybe I should have stayed there. Maybe I should have never left him. Maybe I should have continued doing that. And God is trying to tell us, I'm trying to do a new thing in your life. And if you just look up and look to Jesus and have faith in what Jesus can do for you, oh, good God Almighty, he can do some great things in your life. Here it is. The devil wants to steal, kill, and destroy. The devil wants you to hold on to what you used to be. The devil wants you to hold on to what you used to do. The devil wants you to hold on to all the mess that you was in. But God said through his son, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And when I look up to Jesus, I'm looking up to Jesus to do a new thing. I have faith in my Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. The devil wants to destroy your witness. He wants you to doubt our Lord and Savior. And if he can get you to doubt God, to doubt our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, he got you. But here it is. Jesus wanted you to understand that if you just have faith in him, if you just look to Jesus, everything will be all right. Good God Almighty. How many of you know that you're dealing with a defeated enemy? Oh, I'm telling you, when Jesus died and rose, he defeated Satan. And when Satan comes at you, I want you to understand that you're dealing with a defeated enemy. You're dealing with somebody that already lost. Good God Almighty. Somebody needs to hear that today. You're giving credit, too much credit to the enemy. He has been defeated. And if you just trust and believe in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and have faith in him, he'll see you through. The other piece is that the devil made Jesus do this because Jesus wanted you to know the extent of God's love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Would you give up your child to save mankind? You ain't got to answer that question, but God did it. He gave up his son to save us. He gave up his only son to save us, wretched, sinful, wicked, no good, dirty. God said, I'm gonna give up my son. I'm gonna sacrifice my son so that you can have eternal life. That's love, baby. That's love. He gave up his son so that I can have life, so that I can have it more abundantly. Many of you are waddling and wanting love in all the wrong places. Oh, God Almighty. But God has a love for you that knows no end. God loves you more than the devil hates you, because he gave his son that you might have life and have it more abundantly. He gave his son's life so that you can receive what God had in store for you. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply staying within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From the waters he lifted me. Now safe am I. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. It was love that brought you out of your mess. It was love that brought you back to God. It was love that made you whole. To know the extent of God's love is just to look at your own life. The extent of God's love extends beyond what we can ever imagine or think of. When you think you have done something that makes you unworthy of God's love, you haven't even touched the surface, baby. God still loves you even then. And the great thing about God's love is that it can bring you out of what you are into. Oh, good God Almighty, because it exposes you and presents you with a life that is better than what you were living before. Good God Almighty. Here it is, and I close on this point. The last point, the devil made me do it. Jesus did what he did so that you would know how to magnify God's grace in your life. Let me break this down for you, for it comes out of verses 19 to 21. He talks about light and darkness. He talks about the evil deeds, and he talks about the truth, okay? I'm gonna break it down for you, and I want you to understand this. What Jesus is saying here, what Jesus is saying is that he is the truth, but you must take the truth and compare it to yourself. And when you recognize that you fall short of who Jesus is compared to yourself, you will come to the light and let God know who you really are. In other words, you will repent for your sins. And when you repent for your sins, when you come to the light and recognize that you're not all that you claim to be and receive the forgiveness of God, then what happens is you magnify God's grace in your life. Because for an unbeliever, you magnify God's judgment. But when you give your life to Christ and repent for your sins and come to the light, you magnify God's grace. One activates God's judgment. The other one activates God's heart. And when you magnify God's grace, good God Almighty, you recognize and say, God, I thank you for not what I used to be. Oh, good God Almighty. But I thank you for where I am today. Oh, Lord, have mercy. You magnify God's grace. Many of us, if not all of us, have experienced God's grace. We was not always what we claim to be. We was not always what we tell people we are. But thanks be to God. His grace saved me. His grace delivered me. His grace cleaned me up. His grace turned me around. His grace delivered me. His grace brought me through. When we are straight up with God and recognize
that we are not all that in a bag of chips, that we are filthy rags. We magnify God's grace in our lives. How many of you was not perfect? I'm talking to those who ain't been saved all their life. You were not perfect, but because of God's grace, he looked out for you. Because you recognized that you were not always what you used, what you were supposed to be. And so you came to God, asked his forgiveness, and God cleans you up. That's the anointing. The anointing is, I wasn't always what I claimed to be. I was in the dirt too, but God's grace cleaned me up. Many of you have been looking at and hearing about Kirk Franklin's situation with his son. And many of us are talking about, how can a man of God talk like that to his son? I don't know where you stand on that, and I ain't here to debate it with you. But many of us, if not all of us, have came to a point where instead of quoting scripture, we quoted something else. We were not perfect in our actions. But Kirk Franklin came out and said, hey, I should not have done it. And I ask that you forgive me and pray for me. I don't know about you, but if my children disrespect me, there's going to be some issues. Amen. And I want us to understand and know that we are not always perfect and we fall short from time to time. But when we come to God and seek his forgiveness and ask God to clean me up from the floor up, we magnify God's grace in our lives. Oh, I'm not condoning sin, and I'm not giving you a guard to go in sin. But what I am telling you is that when you fall short, when you know you haven't done right, what you do is you seek God and recognize that God's grace can save you. God's grace can clean you up. God's grace can turn you around. How many of you have been recipients of God's grace? Amen. I ain't asking you to tell me what you done. I ain't asking you to tell me what you did. I ain't even asking you to tell me your stuff, because you know it. Because if it had not been for the Lord on your side, if it had not been for the Lord cleaning you up, you would not be here today giving God the praise. I don't know about you, but I'm a grace child. How many of you are grace children? Amen. We are saved by grace through faith. Amen. How many of you are grace children? Amen. Oh, good God Almighty. How many of you have been some places you should not have been and found out that all hell broke loose when you gave, when you left? But grace be to God. How many of you have done something and you know some folks died from the same thing you did, but you're standing here today? Grace be to God. How many of you have lied about something? Amen. And the persons that you know who did the same thing went to jail, but you're still here today, not in jail. Grace be to God. How many of you messed up in a relationship? Amen. And everything went squat, but the Lord allowed you to have a new relationship, and it's better than the first relationship. Grace be to God. Oh, good God Almighty. That's the, oh Lord, that's how you magnify God's grace. You come clean about who you are. Amen. Don't profess to be something that you're not. The testimony is, you're not what you used to be, but God has made you who you are today. And it was only because of his grace and his mercy. The devil made me do it. To God be the glory. To God be the praise. Amen. Amen. We now want to extend the invitation to discipleship. We extend the invitation to discipleship? Is there one, or is there some who wish to give their life to Christ? Is there one, or is there some who wish to rededicate today? Come back to when you said yes to his will and yes to his way. Is there one who wish to give their life to Christ? Is there one who wish to rededicate today? Come back to when you said yes to his will and yes to his way. We extend the invitation to discipleship. If you're on your phone, hit star 6, unmute yourselves. And when you unmute yourselves, speak up and speak out and then mute yourselves back. If you're on your computer, unmute yourselves there. Speak up and speak out and mute yourselves back. Or you can use the chat option. The invitation to a discipleship is extended. Is there one? Is there one? The door of the church is open. The door of the church is open. Is there one? Is there one? Is there one? Is there one? Invitation to discipleship. Well, if you're saved and you know it, give God praise where you are. Amen. Amen. And amen. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. We now prepare for prayers for the people. Brother Nelson Simmons will be leading us in that. And I ask that you now lift up your prayer request. You can unmute your line to speak. Hit star 6 and speak up. Or you can unmute yourselves on your computer and speak as well. Or you can use the chat option. Let me take this moment to acknowledge a few that are on the line that we've been praying for. First, we want to just lift up Sister Joanne Henry, who's with us today, Sister Maxine Smith, Sister Bobby Bryant. Amen. We thank and praise God for them joining us today. Amen. Sister Lisa Harding is bringing greetings from, let me just look at that. I want to get that right. Bringing greetings from PMBC under Pastor William Foster. Thank you for joining us, Sister Lisa Harden. Kayla is asking prayers for me and my family. All right. Okay. Let me go. Raymond Belcher, prayers for the Belcher and Craig family. On the 17th, Rose Craig will, of course, celebrate her 92nd birthday in heaven. Absolutely. Happy heavenly birthday, Sister Craig. We love and miss you. Absolutely. Lisa Harden is asking prayers for her family. Carmelita is asking prayers for Tiffany and Tracy. As they get close to their mother's birthday. Absolutely. Okay. All right. Any other? Go ahead.
A prayer for Queen Mother and the people that are part of the prison ministry. We will be leading Johnny Beal home after 51 years. We can all meet him. He has faith in God. He's coming out after 51 years in prison. Thank you.
Amen. 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 Let me recognize, thank you, Reverend St. Clair. We'll keep that lifted in prayer. Yeah. Judge Lampkin, please continue to pray for my uncle, Columbus. He is 98, having issues with his sight. Also, my aunt Maxine, 92, and the Lampkin family. Pray for Jackie and Aaron. Absolutely. Jackie is back home, but Aaron
is in Aaron, Brother Aaron Ridgely is in the hospital. So please keep him lifted in prayer. We also want to acknowledge the presence of Sister Corny Gardner, who is with us. Amen. We've been praying for her, and she has returned back to the family. And we just thank and praise God for you, Sister Corny, for being with us today. Amen. It's just a joy to have you back. All right.
Pat, I'm asking prayer continuously for my cousin Ray Alloway.
Yes.
In Boston, Massachusetts. He's waiting a kidney replacement. So please keep him in prayer.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We have D. Just pray that God will keep us in his care, thanking God for his grace. Amen. Carol Mitchell, continue prayers let me get to that. Continue prayers for the Coleman, Austin, Mitchell families. Also prayers for Miss Martin and Debbie Johnson. Absolutely. Yolanda Dawes, prayers for the Dawes family and the entire St. Paul family. Keisha Nixon, my cousin died from COVID. My niece grandmother's on life support with COVID. My Lord. We will lift them up, Keisha. We will lift them up. If you can, put their names in the chat. Put their names in the chat. Chrissy is asking prayers for health and healing of the land, all students and teachers. Prayers for grace and mercy and forgiveness for our sins. Prayers for the Turnage and Rafer family. Prayers for protection and the St. Paul family. Trina is asking prayers for Josephine Ridgely, Aaron's mother, who is also in the hospital. We will definitely do that. Okay. I believe I may have missed one. Let me make sure I got it. Yes, so the Orange Crew, thank God for protection and for answered prayers for healing. Praying for all of our youth and young adults, bereaved family, student, teachers, parents, and administration. That's from the Owens family. All right. Okay.
Yeah, I'd like to pray for myself, my family, my St. Paul family, and Brenda Rogers.
All right. Thank you. And sister, you heard Sister Brodus. Prayer request. Sister Daphne is asking prayer for every situation. And Sister Nixon put her family members who have the one who died from COVID and, of course, the one who is still fighting COVID. So those names are in the chat now. All right. Are there any other prayer concerns or requests? All right. Nelson, we are in your hands, young man.
Hello, everyone. I'm Nelson Simmons. Please bow your heads and close your eyes as I pray. For everybody who's been coming to certain things. Dear Lord, we just lift up your name today to say thank you for everything you've done in our lives. And we also want to lift up some people and some things that have been going through some hard times in their lives. Please help Tiffany and Tracy Smith as they are going through hard times. Please help Sister Jacqueline Prince and Diana Belcher. Please just help the safety of our youth, young adults, teachers, students, and anyone who may be needing to be blessed in your hands. We pray for your overwhelming grace and mercy that we know we don't deserve it, that you still give it to us. We thank you for that. We pray for the Coleman, Austin, and Mitchell family, and the Doss family as well. We especially pray for the Nixon family as unfortunately they lost some family members due to COVID And we pray for one of their family members, Mrs. Crawford, who is in the hospital. Just please lift her up, bless her, that she will get better and have a full recovery. We pray for the Turnage family and the Ridgely family, as they have two family members in the hospital. Please lift them up. Please bless them. And please help them have an also a speedy recovery. And just please lift them up in your hands. And we know that whatever happens, it's your will, and that we will be content with the outcome. Please just bless our safety in the world and in America. Please help anyone who's going through a hard time. Please help any of the homeless, and also bless my grandmother, Johnny Norvell, as her cousin is just going through a hard time also. We lift up to you everything that is, that has been said and that is unsaid. We lift up to you every praise that we have, even though not many were said, we know we still have many, many, many praises for you. Please help all of the people out on the streets who can't find food or who don't have family members to go to. Please help all of the non-believers that they will turn to you, and that they will just learn to love one another and to love you even more. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Nelson, for that prayer. We ask now that you would take a moment to sow a seed into our ministry here at St. Paul. We have three ways in which you can do it. If you go through your bank and do it through Zelle, the recipient would be St. Paul, CME Church. And then the address you would use, which is the email address, would be spministries@comcast.net. That's spministries@comcast.net. The other way we have is you can go directly to our website, stpaulcme-shy.com. Click on the link entitled Online Giving and select a donation category. And then last but not least, you can always mail in your donation, your offering to the church, St. Paul CME Church, 4644 South Dearborn Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60609. Make it care of the steward board. Be sure that in all three options that you identify the category you are giving to, whether it be tithes, Sunday school, general funds, as well as tries for Christ, whatever you are giving to, make sure that you identify that in the memo section. Thank you so much for those who will be giving, who wanted to give, and those who could not give. And we just thank you for your heart and your sacrifice. Thank you so much. What's coming up next, St. Paul, remember I shared with you earlier that Sister Jacqueline Prince and Kim, Sister Kimberly Owens will be giving out the Easter speeches. Thank you, the Easter speeches. So please give her a call, give them a call rather, so that you can receive your Easter speeches. I am putting the number in the chat for you to reach out to Sister Jackie, and if Sister Kimberly Owens can put her contact information into the chat, and you'll have both, so that you can get your Easter speeches for Resurrection Sunday. Also, don't forget March 16th, we will have our leadership retreat follow-up. So leaders, officers, those who desire to lead, please be in that meeting. We will be led by Brother Rawson Simmons and Gwen Ross. And I've been told that You need to bring reports. So those particular leaders, you need to bring reports and identify what you have done up to this point to work on the goals and vision that we placed forth in our church this conference year. And then on Thursday, we will have the National Youth and Young Adult Parents and Attendee Meeting. And that will take place at 7 p.m. And please be mindful of that. We need everyone there. We have to make some decisions going forward, and having everyone there will help us to make the right decision as it relates to the National Youth and Young Adult Conference, which will be held virtually this year. And then last but not least, the candidates forum that will take place on the 19th. And you have that Zoom link information. And for those who want to know who is running for the Episcopacy, you don't want to miss that candidates forum. That concludes what's coming up next at St. Paul. Amen. Junior stewards and stewards, be mindful to segue into our meeting this after service, stewards and junior stewards. And again, I want to thank our many visitors and guests who joined us today. Lisa Harden, D, Carol Barnett, Cassandra Owens, we want to thank you for joining us today. There may be others that we have missed. Just throw your name in the chat. And we definitely want to acknowledge your presence today. And of course, it's just a joy to have Sister Corny Gardner and Sister Joanne Henry, Maxine Smith, and Sister Bryant, Bobby Bryant, who are with us, who we've been praying for. And we thank God for Sister Jacqueline Prince being released from the hospital. Amen. So again, we just thank you all. Let us now prepare for the benediction. Let us now receive the benediction. It is my prayer to God for you that the Lord would bless you and keep you, that the Lord would make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you, that the Lord would lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. And everyone together say, amen.